Tool palettes are used in AutoCAD or ARES Commander to improve productivity with customized tools. In addition to using them yourself, you can import and export them to share the palettes with colleagues. The pre-configured tool palettes provided with ARES Commander give you some examples of palettes. But the most important thing to understand is that you can create your own, featuring the tools of your choice. You can also add new palettes or simply import one that was previously created. ARES Commander uses the same XTP file format as AutoCAD, so palettes created in one program can be used in the other. The simplest way to create a palette is to add shortcuts to specific commands. In this example, it's the line command. But you can go further and customize each command to use predefined settings, such as a layer, color, line type, or line weight. For example, the cold water tool is a line, but with a predefined thickness and blue color. Likewise, you can not only add blocks to your palettes, but also pre-configure how they will be inserted. For instance, with a predefined scale and rotation value. There are different ways to open the tool palette. In the ribbon, the tool palettes are found on the Insert tab. You can also type the command Tool Palettes, or just use the alias TP. Alternatively, you can press Ctrl-3. And, as with other palettes, you can right-click in the ribbon area, then select it from the menu that appears. The default tabs can be modified. For example, you can change the order, moving them up or down. We can also rename them. We can even add separators and title sections. Remember to save your changes to the palettes by clicking here. Now let's see our first method for adding content. The easiest way to add a block to your palette is to drag and drop it. In the same way that we can drag and drop hatches or gradients. The hatch palette shows many examples of this. You can also add dynamic blocks or custom blocks, Lisp routines, and much more. For annotations, you can also add dimensioning tools with specific styles. Now we return to our pre-configured entities. Here we have some lines that are in the wall layer with a specific thickness, color, and line type. We can also drag and drop one to the palette. This particular line has an assigned thickness and belongs to a specific layer. We can see its properties and change something if we wish. The same options dialog is offered for blocks and any tool added to your palette. Let's rename the tool and try it. Note that we are working on layer 0. So normally, the entities should be created on this layer. But my tool has a predefined layer and is therefore using all the settings we have saved, including the color and line type, as well as the layer related to the walls. Following the same steps, you can create your own tools. Now, let's start a new drawing. Note that we don't have a layer for walls in this drawing. Nevertheless, the wall tool we created can be used in this new drawing. Using this tool, the missing layer will be created, and the entity will keep the same thickness, line type, and color. Drag and drop is the easiest method, provided you are using this palette only for yourself. If your goal is to share your palette with other users, recall that blocks are external references and will not be exported. The solution, which is also used in AutoCAD, is to place your blocks or dynamic blocks on a network drive and add them to your tool palette afterward. Let's open the Design Resources palette for that purpose. In this palette, I can find content even without opening the drawings. I could take one specific block from this drawing, for example. Most interestingly, I can select a folder on my network drive and right-click to add all the blocks it contains as a tool palette. That said, if your intention is to share a block library, we invite you to consider the new Trinity Block Library, which is a more modern and efficient option. Once your palette is created, you can export it. As explained earlier, we use the same XTP file format as AutoCAD. Therefore, this new palette can be shared with other users, whether they are running ARES Commander or AutoCAD. To further organize your tool palettes, you can group them by type. Here in the drop-down, we can see some groups have been created for us. To reorganize or create new groups, we can use the Customize Palette option. In this dialog, we can create groups and define which palettes will be seen in each one. We just have to drag them. Of course, a palette can be visible in multiple groups. We can easily remove a palette from any group. We could even rename a palette from here. Finally, we can export a group of palettes or the entire set of palettes in the XPG format, which is also compatible with AutoCAD. Leveraging groups, we can work more efficiently by selecting the group that is most appropriate for our current drawing.